Hey guys, Miro here, how you have been doing? Since I released my latest video on curve support in geometry nodes a few months ago, I got lots of questions how I made lampposts to follow the curve. And that's what we are going to have a look at in this tutorial. Tutorial is split into two parts. In the first one, I explain how I made lampposts to follow the curve in the previous video, which I consider the old approach, but it still may be valid for someone. And in the second part, I reveal a different, more robust or more precise approach. So let's start with the old approach first. The first step is to get points scattered on a profile extruded along the spline and then limit point scattering in the z-axis. We need to use two curve objects. One is the main curve and the other is the profile curve. Keep in mind that the profile one has to go along the y-axis. And now let's connect them to curve to mesh node. Add point distribute node set to Poisson disk and the point instance and join geometry node as well so we can easily see what is going on. Now let's adjust the length of the profile curve to limit points scattering only to one dimension. We can move upper control point down along the y-axis almost to zero. Extruded profile is now so thin that it looks like points are scattered along the curve. Let's now take to our advantage the fact that scattered points inherit normals of the faces they are being scattered on and switch a cube to lamppost model. And add align rotation to vector node and change the axis to Z. And this is basically it. You can now play with minimum distance slider to set the lamppost spacing. There are a few problems worth to mention though. The fact that points are scattered randomly makes it impossible to be stationary. So if I move with curve's control points, scattered points get randomized again and therefore there's this weirdly looking popping in and out. Also, a user has to make sure that there's always enough points generated, so random gaps won't appear. But it's really hard to determine what the right density should be, and setting the density to high amounts may worsen performance of the modifier. Let's now have a look at the second approach. We again will be using main curve and the profile curve, but this time profile curve will go along positive x-axis. I set the right control point position to 0.1. Also, let's make sure that there won't be any additional points on the profile curve. You can change it either here or use resample curve node and set count to 2. In this approach, we are going to calculate normals on each point of the evaluated curve by subtracting the position of this point from this point. To do so, we will need two separated sets of points. The first one are the evaluated points from the original curve. The second one are points from evaluated extruded profile. First of all, we have to calculate distances of extruded profile points, these ones, from domain curve points. Clearly, the distance will be either 0 for these points, as they share the same position as points from the main curve, or the distance will be 0.1, because that's the length of our profile curve. So let me quickly set up attribute proximity node. And in the spreadsheet, you can now see that the distance is either 0 or 0.1. For further processing, we need only points with the distance 0.1. So we filter them with the attribute compare node. And now let's physically wipe them out with point separate node. In spreadsheet, you can now see only points with distance 0.1, and the same happens in the viewport. Okay, three more nodes and we are done. Let's now calculate a normal for each point by using position of our points, which are stored in the pose attribute, and subtract them from main curve's points positions. So P underscore normal attribute now holds normals, which we are going to use to make instances to follow the curve. But before we do so, we have to reset offset so our points get back to main curve. Before we do the final step, let's actually instance lamppost and change the curve a little bit so the necessity of the last node is more obvious. As you can see, all lampposts are now aligned along the y-axis. That's the rotation or orientation of the original lamppost. To make them to follow the curve, let's add the align rotation to vector node, set axis to y, change vector to attribute, and use our P underscore normal, and voila, we made lampposts to follow the curve. In case you would need to flip lamp's orientation, use point rotate node, or you can just swap the order of position attributes subtraction. Okay, so from here you can start adding more functionality like control over number of lampposts with the resample curve node, or control over the orientation based on which side of the road the lampposts are. Using this second approach, I have recently made a prototype of a railway generator that is part of my add-on called Blendscape Tools, which I use to generate content for virtual landscapes for games. There are more generators under the hood, like this orchard generator, and my plan is to start showcasing features of each individual generator in the following weeks, so if you wonder what else is possible to do with the help of geometry nodes, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, so you won't miss any update. Thank you for watching and see you soon. Ciao!